of the maintenance planners and schedulers that you've seen, where do you see most people get wrong there? Where do most people go wrong with a maintenance planner and scheduler?
Well, there's quite a few things that where it can go wrong. Yeah, but I think one of the biggest confusions I see in organizations is, especially with organizations as a whole, is we confuse planning with scheduling. And mm-hmm. and that becomes because we treat them almost as synonyms, right? But really in the planning and scheduling process, they're very different steps and phases. So planning is all about getting the work ready to execute. It's about making sure that you understand what needs to be done, how it needs to be done, the spare parts, the tools, the materials, the resources, and getting that all packaged up and being ready to do the job. Scheduling is all about, okay, well, when is this the most efficient way to do it or time? I've got 5 jobs on a piece of equipment, right? Let's schedule them together and take that piece of equipment down and mm-hmm. do all 5 jobs rather than doing it this week one and then again another week and another week and another week. Because in most environments, we have to isolate our equipment, do lockout, tag out, and all those kind of things. That takes time. And if you do that 5 times instead of once and campaigning it, you can drive a lot of efficiency. So I think, you know, planning and scheduling is a big one where people get it wrong. And even when people do understand it, another big problem is that we have maintenance planners that we burden them with admin, right? We get them to do invoices. We get them to do, make sure vendors are paid and all this kind of stuff. But a good maintenance planner needs to be out in the plant, scoping jobs, talking to technicians and pulling all that together. And if you bury him with admin or her with admin, you won't get the value of that planning role. And the other thing is, you know, you then sit, the planner sits stuck behind his desk and doesn't get out to the plant, doesn't get a chance to go and speak to the technicians or the supervisor or have a look at the job site, which then leads to, you know, inefficiencies in the job. The other thing I've seen happen a lot in organizations is they say, oh yeah, planning and scheduling, that's great, let's go and do this. And they'll roll something out, they'll maybe even get people trained and they might even write a procedure or a process how they're going to do it. But then they'll not spend enough time to think about how they're going to impact the people who are working in the process and how that changes their work life and their ways of working. And they're not focusing enough on the change management and the sustainability. And so they push this into the organization. It works for 6 months, maybe 12 or 18 months while the people who are pushing it are busy pushing. But then eventually another initiative comes along or the people who are driving the process move on, get promoted or leave the company. And so often I've seen people or organizations 2 or 3 years down the line, they go, but we had a planning and scheduling process. What's happened? It's all fallen apart because they never set themselves up for kind of long-term success.